This is Adi Sharma Solution, Class 11, Chapter 29, Limits. Exercise is 29.8. Next question is question number 16. Cos root x minus cos cos root x minus cos root a by x minus a. So this is cos c minus cos d. We have seen the expansion of this. Minus 2 sin c plus d by 2 and sin c minus d by 2. And c here is root x and d is root a. Minus 2 sine, this expansion is being written here. Okay, now this denominator is x minus a, so we can write it as how under root x plus under root a multiplied by under root x minus under root a. So a square minus b square, you can use the formula, it will be x minus a. So x minus a can be written like this. So we have minus 2 sine root x plus root a. Now this is by 2 and this I am taking it in below this. We are not going to do anything with this, but still means no limit we are going to apply here. We are going to apply limit here. Sin under root x minus under root a by 2 divided by this one, under root x minus under root a. So these all are together, root x minus root a divided by 2 multiplied by 2, because we want the same term. Now this term here, if you apply the limit extends to a, because limit extends to a is what? Limit extends to a is under root a minus under root a, denominator also under root a minus under root a. That is, you are going to get 0 by 0. So we are applying the limit here. That limit is going to be making it as 1. And 2 gets cancelled here, so minus 1 will remain only. Now sin under root x plus under root a, and now putting under root x as under root a means replacing x by a. So you have 2 again x by a under root a plus under root a, 2 under root a. This will be sin 2 under root a, this 2 cancels, and sin under root a by 2 under root a. This is the final answer here. Now question number 17 here, sin under root x minus sin under root a, and by x minus, same thing we are going to do here, exactly same thing, right? So sin c minus sin d by x minus a. So applying the formula to cos c plus d by 2 sin c minus d by 2, and again x minus a we are writing it under root x plus under root a by under root x minus under root a, and this we are going to use these two together. So multiplying divided by 2 for under root x minus under root a. Now this term, this whole term is going to be 1, same term. Okay, this is 1 and 2 we have introduced, so 2 gets cancelled, 2 cos root x plus root a by 2. Now just apply x as a, so you have cos, and need below also you have root a plus root a, 2 root a. So question number 18 here, 1 minus x square by sin 2 pi x. Now if you see the question, it is looking that it is 2 pi into x. I'll just give you a view. So we are placing x as 1 minus x because x is tending to 1 and h is tending to 0 when we put x as h, 1 minus h. So 1 minus h whole square. Let us solve it. 1 minus a square plus b square minus 2ab, 1 square plus h square minus 2h. 1 gets cancelled, 1 minus 1, and this is minus h square and this is plus 2h, plus 2h. So we have 2h minus h square, this is, and we have 2h minus h square, so h 2 minus h, it will be h 2 minus h. So what are we going to do with this? As I said, it's looking like that it is 2 pi into x it is looking, but it is not like that. In the place of x, you will be tempted to put 1 minus h, that is what we have to put actually. But 1 minus h, this x is coming with this 2 pi x. Okay. So h 2 minus h, and now 2 pi x. In place of x, we are putting this 1 minus h. So it should be sin 2 pi 1 minus h. So we are going to expand it. Sin 2 pi minus 2 pi h it will be. I'm trying to suggest that, I'm just telling what this exactly is. This is sine 2 pi x, sine 2 pi, 2 pi, and 1 minus h. So sine 2 pi minus 2 pi h. So sine 180 minus theta we have to see. That will be sine 180 minus theta. That should be the coffee if you do. 180 minus theta, so cos is only positive, sine is going to be negative. Sine 2 pi h it will come. So what you have, h 2 minus h by minus negative of 2 sine pi h. Okay. So sine 2 pi h, h is already there. So just put h here. And you need a 2 pi also. So multiply this by 2 pi divide by 2 pi. Okay. Now let us apply the limit. Sine 2 pi h by 2 pi h. This is going to be 1. This is going to be 1. And you have h. H already we have taken. 2 minus h by 2 pi. Negative of 2 pi. Okay. Let's apply the limit. 2 gets cancelled. This apply the limit. This tends to 0. So you have 2 by minus 2 pi. 2 gets cancelled. You have minus 1 by pi. This is going to be final. Question number 19. So we have limit x tends to pi by 4, fx minus f pi by 4 by x minus pi by 4. And this is when fx is given as sine 2x. This is also given here. Fx is sine 2x given. So what is fx? Sine 2x. So just put sine 2x here. I am putting sine 2x. So sine 2x, fx is sine 2x. Replace it. Sine 2x. Now, f pi by 4 is, we have to put x as pi by 4. So sine 2, let's make it here. Sine 2 pi by 4. Now this is sine pi by 2. We have sine pi by 2 here. Then in place, I'll just place x as pi by 2 plus h, but just now. First x minus pi by 4. Will it be like this? X minus pi by 4. Okay. Now let us apply the limit now. We have x, limit is x tends to pi by 4. So we are taking, put x as pi by 4 plus h. Pi by 4 plus h. Okay. H is tending to 0. So I am putting x as pi by 2, pi by 4 plus h. Pi by 4 minus h also you can put. Pi by 4 plus h is better. We will see just now. Minus sign pi by 2 in place of x, if you put pi by 4 plus h, pi by 4 plus h minus pi by 4, pi by 4, pi by 4 gets cancelled, only h will remain. Otherwise, if you put pi by 4 minus h, it will be minus h in the denominator. That will be, you know, negative will be an issue, but it's better to have pi by 4 plus h. So h is in the denominator. Now multiply this 2 inside, sine 2 into pi by 4, that is sine pi by 2 plus 2h. You have sine 90 plus h, sine 90 plus theta. What is sine 90 plus theta? It is cos, and we add sugar to coffee, sine 90 plus theta. So it will be cos 2h plus cos 2h. And what is sine pi by 2? Sine pi by 2 is 1. Sine 90 is 1. So cos 2h minus this is 1 by h. Now this cos 2h minus 1 can be written as, take negative outside. I'm doing it here, minus, you have 1 minus cos 2h, this will be minus 2 sine square h by 2, 2 sine square h by 2. So you have 2 sine square h by 2, and now you have h already there, so no, it will be sine square h, not h by 2, because this is cos 2h. So we are having just h, so I'm having h here, h square, so h we have to have in the numerator also, minus 2 into h it will be. Limit up, we have applied. Now apply the limit for h. H is 0. So minus 2 into 0 will be 0. Minus 2 into 0 will be 0. Okay. It's not sine square h by 2, it's sine square h. Okay. Question number 20. Okay. 1 plus cos pi x by 1 minus x whole square. So here x is tending to 1. Let us put x as 1 minus h first. And then h tends to 0. 1 plus cos pi x is 1 minus h by 1 minus, in place of x we are writing 1 minus h. this is 1 plus cos pi minus pi h. Cos pi minus pi h, cos minus pi minus theta is what? That should be the copy. So cos 180 minus theta. What is cos 180 minus theta? It's going to be negative minus 1 minus cos pi h divided by 1 minus of h. So 1 minus 1 plus h. So h square. It will be h square. Okay, 1 minus cos pi h is what? 2 sine square pi h by 2. 2 sine square pi h by 2. Now in the denominator you need this term pi square h square by 2 square. So pi square here, then if you have pi square, you have to have a pi square here. Then you have pi square, and then you also have need to have a 4 because it's a pi h by 2 whole square. So you need to have a 2 square, 4. So 4. Let me just change it to 4 because it's square of sine, no? So pi h by 2 whole square it will be. So 4 you need. Okay. So this whole term is what? It's going to 1. Sin theta by theta limit h tends to, where theta tends to 0. So this is sin pi h by 2, sin pi by pi h by 2 whole square. This is going to be 1. Okay. Then we have this twice. What is remaining? Twice of pi square by 4. Twice pi square by 4. And to do this cancel, pi square by 2. Pi square by 2 will be the answer. Question number 21. Limit x tends to 1. 1 minus x square by sine pi x. Okay, 1 minus. Now let us take x as, because x is tending to 1. X has 1 minus h cube. So h is tending to 0. So 1 minus h just put here. Then you have sine pi in place of x, just put 1 minus h, pi 1 minus h. So let's deal with the numerator first. 1 minus, we have already seen a question like this. 1 minus 1 plus h square minus 2h, that is a minus b whole square. 1 minus 1 minus h square plus 2h, and then gets cancelled, minus h square by 2h, 2h minus h square, you can write. H you can take common, it's 2 minus h. Okay. Then sine pi minus pi h. Sine pi minus pi h, sine 180 minus theta is what? That should be to coffee. Now it's good to college. Sine 180 minus theta is positive sine. So it will be sine, remain as sine. Sine pi h. Okay, pi h, so you need to have a pi. You already have a h in the numerator. So just take it here. So sin pi h by pi h, and since we have introduced pi, you need to have a pi in the denominator as well. So let me just introduce pi, because this pi was not there, so we ought to have a pi in the denominator. Okay. So pi you can introduce, and h you can have here, sin pi h by pi h now. Okay. So this sine pi h by pi h is going to be 1 when we apply the limit. So 2 minus h by pi will come. This is going to be 1, sine pi h by pi h, apply the limit. It will be 2 minus h by pi. Now apply the limit, h is 0. 2 minus 0 by pi, 2 by pi will come. This is the answer. Question number 22. 1 minus sine 2x by 1 plus cos 4x. The limit x is tending to pi by 4. So x is pi by 4 minus h you are going to write. Limit h is tending to 0. So you have 1 minus sine 2 x, you are placing pi by 4 minus h. And denominator you have 1 plus cos 4 in place of x, again pi by 4 minus h. So 1 minus sine 2 into pi by 4, so it will be pi by 2 and 2h. Sine pi by 2 minus 2h. Multiplying 2 inside, minus 2h. Okay. Denominator you have 1 plus cos pi, 4 multiplying inside, cos pi minus 4h. Cos pi minus 4h. So cos pi minus 4h, cos 180 minus theta is what? Minus cos theta. If you can see here, cos I should go to graphic. Okay. 1 minus cos 4h. Negative it is. Okay. 1 minus it will be, so the numerator denominator of both will become 1 minus cos. Cos. So 1 minus cos 4h in the denominator, 1 minus sin. Sin 190 minus theta is cos theta. Sin 90 minus theta is going to be cos theta. Okay. 1 minus cos 2h divided by 1 minus cos 4h. So we just apply the formula 2 sin square theta by 2. 2 sin square 2h by 2 is h. 2 sin square 4h by 2 is 2h. 2h. So you can just cancel this 2, 2. Now you can introduce this sin square h. Have a h square here. And h square in the numerator. For this. Then you have this sin square 2h. So you have 4h square. You need to have a 4h square. Because it will be 2h square. So we are introducing this. This is going to be 1. This is going to be 1. H square gets cancelled. Only 1 by 4 is going to remain. 1 by 4 is the answer here. This is the answer. Now question number 23 here. So cot square x minus 3 by cosec x minus 2. So we know that cosec square theta minus cot square theta is 1. Cosec square minus cot square is 1. So cot square we can write it as cosec square by theta minus 1. And it is x, so just replace x by theta here. Cot square theta is cosec square theta minus 1. Okay. So cosec square theta minus 1 minus 3. Minus 3 is already there. And what about the denominator? You have cosec x minus 2. Cosec x minus 2. So this becomes cosec square. This you can write as, I am writing just c for cosec. C square minus 4 by c minus 2. So this is c square minus 2 square you can write. So c minus 2, c plus 2. And then c minus 2. C is cosec here, right? C minus 2 cancel. And c plus 2, that is cosec x plus 2 is 0. Now x tending to pi by 2. So pi by 6. Apply cos of cosec pi by 6 plus 2. Cosec pi by 6, you know sine 30 degree, pi by 6 is 30 degree. So we have sine 30 is 1 by 2, so cosec pi by 6 will be 2 plus 2, 2 plus 2 is 4. 4 is the answer here, 4. And now we have 24th question. Now this is quite a straightforward question, right? Don't get worried about this pi by 4 and etc. We can split the limit also to each of the term. We are splitting the limit. Where limit n tends to infinity, limit n tends to infinity, we have n here, then you have sine pi by 4n, then sine pi by 4n, then we are applying again the limit, same thing, n tends to infinity, and cos pi by 4n. It is n tends to infinity, remember that. So when we apply this limit, cos pi by 4 into infinity. What is 1 by infinity? It is 0. So actually it will be 0. Cos 0. And cos 0 is 1. Cos 0 is 1. So now this whole limit is going to be, when you apply the limit, this whole term is going to be 1. Okay, this whole part is 1. So we can forget about it. So we have to deal with this now. N sine pi by 4n. So now, if you apply n as infinity, it will be sine 0. So, it is going to be 0? No. Let us see. It will be y or t, you can take anything. Y as this pi by 4 n. So, when n is tending to infinity, when n is tending to infinity, what does it mean? Pi by 4 into infinity, it will be 0. Okay. So, if y will tend to 0, if n is tending to infinity, y will tend to 0. So limit y tends to 0, and you have this sine pi by 4n we have taken as y, and then in place of n we have to change something, this n. So n is what? N is pi by 4y. It will be pi by 4y. in place of n, just replace 4. I'm taking n over here, so pi by 4 y. Okay, pi by 4 y. Now you see if sin y by pi by 4, you can just take it out. Constant doesn't matter. Sin y by y, limit apply, y tends to 0. This is whole is going to be 1. So pi by 4 is going to be the answer. Okay, this question we are going to take in the next discussion. And then thank you so much. Take care of yourself.